Coming up, I'll show you the updates to the Quantum Development Kit preview, including new support for macOS and the Linux platform, allowing you to write quantum applications as you begin to explore the concepts of quantum computing on those platforms. Back in December, we released the Quantum Development Kit preview for Windows as part of our overall quantum computing strategy, which includes the development of a topological qubit and a quantum computer. We'd like to start by saying thank you to the tens of thousands of you who've downloaded the kit and started writing Q# code. Your feedback has been very valuable, and we're excited to announce an update that delivers the new features that you asked for most. Not only are we bringing the Quantum Development Kit preview to more platforms, but we're also excited to welcome Python programmers to the world of Q#. And remember, if you're new to quantum computing, check out the series on Microsoft Mechanics to learn the core concepts before you get started. The Quantum Development Kit preview for macOS and Linux is integrated with Visual Studio Code for those platforms. The first thing you want to do on your Mac is make sure that you've got the Visual Studio Code and .NET Core SDK 2.0 or later installed. You'll need the Quantum Development Kit extension for VS Code, and you can get that from the Visual Studio Marketplace. Next, you configure the Quantum Development Kit for Mac in your favorite terminal with one command, which you can see here. Then finally, you want to clone our Q# library and samples from GitHub. Now you're ready to build some Q# code. Last time, Krista showed us calculating the ground state of hydrogen, which leveraged Q# and C# functions, as well as graphical output for the analysis. Let's take a look at how this works on the Mac. I've got exactly the same code on the Mac as we showed last time on Windows. Our hydrogen ground state project opens into VS Code, and I have access to all of the source files, including Q# and C# with syntax coloring. Here is the C# driver calling into our Q# code, which does our quantum operations. Now, I'll run this code on my Mac. You'll see that we get similar graphical richness to what we had on Windows, including the predictive plot line and the actual analysis. This is a combination of the Q# runtime talking to the quantum simulator. So you've got a consistent experience from code editing to quantum simulation to analysis across platforms. And you can access the same experience if you're running on Linux. You can find details at the link shown. Now, a lot of quantum research has been done using Python, and today we're making a preview of Python interoperability available on Windows. Let's take a look at how it works. I'll move to a remote session running Windows. In VS Code on Windows, I have a project open that explores quantum tomography, which is the process of testing quantum operations that works the same in quantum simulators as it does on actual quantum computers. The quantum operation that I want to explore is written here in Q#. This operation takes a qubit as a parameter, along with a range of noise that it's going to apply to a Hadamard operation that we'll probe from Python. Over here in my Python code, we're calling a function, single qubit process tomography, that we run 10,000 times. Now, I'll run it. So the first thing it's going to do is initialize our simulator that will be used for simulating this quantum operation. It's now preparing a tomography model that will be applied to that Hadamard channel. And then it begins the process of running those 10,000 iterations of that probing function. Our output shows our predicted results on the right, what we expected the noise to look like. On the left, we see how the tomography process works with the noise we injected. The artifacts appear because we limited the number of measurements to 10,000, but we can clearly see a trend in the quantum operation toward the predicted noise model. We could even improve the accuracy with more iterations. Now, we know that one of the most popular places to work with scientific analysis like this is Jupyter Notebooks. Here in my browser, I have got a Jupyter Notebook open. This Python interoperability works great from Jupyter Notebooks, allowing you to integrate Q# results through Python into the notebooks you're already using. So you can see here, we have the exact same results from our tomography example embedded directly into our Jupyter Notebook. One more thing to note, we've also improved the speed and efficiency of our quantum simulator, which will be especially noticeable for simulations requiring 20 or more qubits. I hope you've enjoyed our introduction to the latest updates to our Quantum Development Kit, which brings support for macOS and Linux-based development, as well as a preview of Python interoperability. You can get started by downloading the latest previews for Linux and macOS at the link shown. Oh, and one last thing. We know that many of you find the source code in our libraries, samples, and tutorials really useful, and you want to use that code in your own projects. So we've made these fully open source on GitHub to allow you to build on top of our code and contribute your ideas back to the Q-Sharp Quantum community. You can find out more about quantum computing and Microsoft's approach at microsoft.com/quantum. Keep the feedback coming, and thanks for watching.